Yes, sir, Mr. Chair. At this time, the county will call Ms. Joanne Fisher, Mrs. Joanne Fisher, excuse me.
Yeah, right, right up there in the conference chair. Thank you for your time this morning, appreciate you waiting. I would ask that you state your name for the record, please.
Joanne Fisher.
And you were sworn in earlier, correct?
Yes.
Mrs. Fisher, do you know Monte Cuohosi?
Yes, that's my mom.
That's your mother? And where do you live?
Sarasota.
And in October of 2013, did you also live in Sarasota?
Yes.
And are you employed?
Yes.
Where do you work?
Sarasota Classified Teachers Association.
What's the nature of your work that you do there?
I represent teachers. It's a union.
Now, do you recall on October 23rd, 2013, receiving a phone call from your mother?
Yes.
And what did she tell you?
Well, she said that the sheriff of police had come to our house looking for my nephew, and that she was handcuffed, and they searched her house, and somebody had their gun drawn, and she was just very distraught about the whole incident. And she was just very upset.
Did she appear afraid?
Oh, yes, yes.
What did you do after talking with your mother?
I tried to call the sheriff's office because she didn't have the information. She didn't remember who it was or anything. So I believe I looked online and tried to find her phone number. I called a phone number and tried to get a hold of somebody, you know, to file a complaint. I had asked about filing a complaint. And I believe I called a couple times and left a message with maybe a secretary or somebody about the complaint, and I finally got through to someone.
Okay. And did you speak with a man or a woman when you got through?
The final person that I told the story to was a man.
And did he identify himself by name? Did he tell you his name?
I don't remember if he told me his name. He probably did. I don't remember.
Did he tell you he was the person that you were calling about?
No, I definitely know he didn't do that. I would never file a complaint with the person I was complaining
about. Did he tell you that he knew or that he was there with your mother when the incident occurred that your mother described to you on the phone?
No.
Okay. Well, what did he tell you?
Well, he said he'd file a report and call me back.
And did he say that he would send you the report?
I don't know that he said he'd send it, but he said he'd contact me because I left my information.
And did he contact you?
No.
Did anybody contact you?
No, not until I think it was last year I was contacted. That's the only time I've been contacted.
So the first contact you had was from District Swift?
Yes.
Now, when you first contacted the sheriff's office, did you know who you were trying to complain about?
No, no, no. Like I said, my mother was just distraught and upset, and I was angry, so I was just trying to find a supervisor or somebody to complain to, because I had no idea who anybody was.
Well, how did you anticipate filing a complaint about somebody you didn't know about?
Well, I assumed I gave him my mom's name and address and what had happened. So I assumed there was somebody that took complaints, and they gave me something to talk to. So,
is it accurate to say that you were waiting until they called you back?
Yes, yes. It was my understanding that somebody would contact me. I didn't think I needed to do anything else.
Okay. And then what happened?
Well, just time passed. I mean, things, you know, get busy, and I live in Sarasota, so, you know, no one contacted me. At one point, I asked my mom if she wanted me to contact the sheriff himself, and she said no. It was really traumatizing for her, and this whole event has been a process. It's been horrible for her, and so she just, you know, figured nobody was going to do anything. No one had contacted us, so why bother?
Now, when you were talking to the man on the phone, did you tell him what your mother had reported to you about handcuffs and searching?
Yes.
And what was his response?
He said he'd look into it.
He would look into it and get back to you?
Yes.
Now, if the man you had talked to by telephone was the person who had carried out these activities in your mother's home, did he tell you that?
No. Again, I would have never, even if I was calling Publix to complain about somebody, if they told me they were the person I was complaining about, I'd ask for somebody's boss. I would never file a complaint with the person that I was accused, you know, accusing of doing something.
Why would you file a complaint with the very person who?
Because it would be common sense that they may not take down the information accurately or report it to somebody. I mean,
would they have any interest in doing so? Self-interest?
Well, I assume anybody might not want to report themselves if they could get in trouble. I don't know. That's just my thought. At the time, I didn't think that's why I didn't call. I just assumed they filed a report. Maybe that stuff happens. I've never done it before. Maybe they just don't do anything about it.
Have you ever filed a complaint with the police office before?
No.
How does it make you feel that someone from the Volusia County Sheriff's Office handcuffed your mother, searched her house, and then when you called for an explanation, he refused to identify himself as being the person responsible for those activities?
Just objective relevancy of what her feelings are about this.
What was the objection?
The objection is this witness's feelings about how her mother was treating her views of the Volusia County Sheriff's Office. I don't think are relevant to these disciplinary proceedings.
What does it tell you about the Volusia County Sheriff's Office when you have someone with the Sheriff's Office handcuff your mother and search her house? And when you call for an explanation, they don't identify that they're the ones who are responsible for those activities.
Same objection.
Well, let me respond to your objection, because I thought that in the purpose of termination was to give back the public perception of the Sheriff's Department. Am I correct in that?
Yeah, that's right. One of the offenses is misconduct.
I wouldn't trust the Sheriff's Department. After that happened, it's definitely a negative view on the Sheriff's Department. I grew up in Volusia County, and it was really the first time I had to deal with them, and it was pretty upsetting, and it's been very upsetting for my mother to deal with this.
And what do you think about him telling you that he would contact you and follow up, and then he never did?
Well, that makes me angry, because I had no, whatever the process is, maybe it needs to be corrected, but I had no knowledge that I had filed a report with the person that I was accusing of it, so it makes me angry that I wasn't told.
Okay. What impression do you have of the Volusia County Sheriff's Office as a result of your mother's experience?
That's very negative. I mean, this has been terrible for my mother. I mean, she was 80 years old at the time, and it was bad.
Did your experience cause you to lose confidence in the Volusia County Sheriff's Office?
Yes.
Did your experience cause you to lose trust in the Volusia County Sheriff's Office?
And Mr. Chairman, and then his personal board. One of the stipulations we entered into to hopefully speed this process a little bit was, since we have cross-referenced witnesses, we've said any witness on your list is also witness on ours, that we can go beyond the scope of direct if needed, although it may not be necessary, just so that the witness doesn't have to be recalled.
I won't object to him going beyond the scope as long as it's relevant.
Very good, thank you.
Good morning.
Thanks for morning, Ms. Fisher.
How are you? Ms. Fisher, are you certain that when you made the call on behalf of your mother sometime in October of 2013 that person did not identify themselves?
Well, he never identified himself. He never identified himself as being the person I was talking about.
Okay.
Now, he may have said his name, but his name meant nothing to me because I never knew the names of anybody who came to the house.
Okay. And when you called on behalf of your mother, were you expressing her emotions about the event or your own reaction to how you felt your mother had been treated?
Probably both, because my mother told me the story. I only had her information, but also the information I was given by her that she was handcuffed, her house was searched, threatened her to go to jail. I would think it was both. I mean, I believe what happened was wrong, but of course, emotionally, my mother was distraught, so that came under play, too.
As a result of what your mother expressed to you, did she have to, or did you have to assist her, I should say, with seeking any counseling or anything like that?
Oh, you mean like professional counseling?
Yes.
Emotionally?
Yes, ma'am.
No. My mother's not a counseling kind of person.
She has told us in this hearing just a little while ago that she was more angry than anything. Would you agree?
Yes.
If that's the state of mind you found your mother to be more angry?
Well, not when she called me. She was more upset. You know, I don't know if she had calmed down by that point, but she was more upset than angry.
Do you recall if she, when she relayed her account of the events, did she mention an officer coming in with a gun drawn into her home?
Yes, yes. She said that somebody had a gun and they were going room to room.
Did she give you a physical description of that officer?
No, but I can't say that I asked her for a description.
From your listening to your mother and hearing her side of the story, was it your perception that it was the gun being drawn in her home that upset her more, or was it the actions of the officer that had cuffed her?
Well, I think that everything was upsetting from start to finish, but the handcuff was upsetting and the threatening and then the gun. I think the gun probably scared her.
Okay. And when you were dialoguing with the person about what your mother had related to you, did you give her a recount of that fact that there was a gun allegedly drawn as well?
I believe so. I think the major things I talked, it's been a long time, but I think, I don't know about the gun piece, but I know the handcuffing, the searching, and the threatening. The gun piece may, you know, it's been a while. I don't know if she gave me that information after I called, because I called right after what happened. We had tons of discussions about it afterwards, so I don't want to say that I definitely mentioned the gun at that point.
And I believe you called that same day, October 23rd, 2013?
Yes, I called after it happened. Like I said, I don't remember. I just know she called me. I was at work.
Okay.
And then I called.
And by way of your own background, ma'am, what is your extending your formal education? But I mean, do you have some college?
I have a master's degree from UCF.
Okay. And what field of study?
Education.
Okay. And what was your occupation? presentation back in October 13?
I worked for the teachers union.
Okay. And in the course of your duties at that time, did you deal with complaints on occasion when you were working for the teachers union?
I deal with those all the time.
Okay.
Not about us, but about teachers having issues.
Yes, ma'am. So you're familiar with at least a process whereby complaints are handled in the course of your duties at that time?
I guess.
Okay.
You know, I'm not directly or kind of inside to the way they complain maybe to the school district.
Okay. The reason I ask that is, ma'am, if you, what you're telling me is, I believe you're sworn, your type written transcript of your testimony that you gave last year, you indicated that you were expecting some information to come back to you, correct?
Yes.
You never received that, correct?
Yes, that's correct.
At that time, you didn't take any further steps in terms of submitting a written complaint, is that correct?
No.
Did you even go to the Volusia County Sheriff's Office website and see where there's a drop down tab for making a complaint?
No.
Is it fair to say, though, that if you felt your mother had been treated so severely badly enough, for lack of a better word, or been mistreated in such a fashion, you would have taken additional steps?
No. What happened was, he didn't get back to me. I talked to my mother about it. She really is fearful of the sheriff's office department. She didn't want me to pursue it. She felt like if me pushing it, and to be honest with you, to this day she's uncomfortable. She feels uncomfortable being here because she's afraid.
And you said you grew up in Volusia County.
Yes.
Correct. And you'd never had a bad encounter with law enforcement, correct?
No.
There haven't been any unpleasant encounters since October 23rd, 2013, is that correct?
No. I mean, I haven't been. I live in Sarasota, so I'm not here that often.
Okay. And are you aware your mother has given two statements, one in April and one in November of last year?
Yeah, one, I believe, is in Tampa.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
And so you're aware your mother has cooperated in this in the internal investigation,
yes,
correct?
Yes.
Your mother hasn't had, well, strike that. Has your mother conveyed to you any problems that she's had with the Volusia County Sheriff's Office as a result of now making a verbal complaint this many years later?
No. I'm not saying that they're realistic fears. I'm just saying she's nervous.
Okay. And her first interview was literally almost a year ago, April 17, are you aware of that?
Yes.
Has your mother reported any problems whatsoever from the Volusia County Sheriff's Office?
No.
And just so we're clear, I believe this is in the record, so I'll make sure you agree. This is the first time I've met or spoken with you, is that correct, Ms.
Yes.
Fisher? You did not actively reach out to the sheriff's office even in 2017 on behalf of your mother in this matter, correct?
No. I don't know what you mean. I was contacted by the detective.
Yeah. Lieutenant Jason Sawicki is the one who contacted you, correct?
Yes.
Justin,
I'm sorry. The gentleman seated right here?
Yes.
Okay. So without you or your mother, to your knowledge, initiating any complaint, it was Detective Lieutenant Sawicki that reached out to you?
Yes.
And I wrote something down on your direct testimony here today. You said you never would have filed a complaint with a person with whom you had the complaint. Is that correct?
That I was filing a complaint about. If he had told me he was the person that was in my mother's house, I would have.
Isn't it true when you did speak
with the person, and we'll say it was Captain Brown on October 23rd, 13. You never said you wanted to make a complaint, did you?
Yes, I did.
So if Captain Brown testifies in this proceeding that you never said that, you disagree with that?
I definitely disagree.
But even if you weren't satisfied with his response, there was nothing that prohibited you or your mother, to your knowledge, from proceeding with a written complaint.
No, he never. He told me that he was looking into it to file a complaint. I didn't think I needed to do anything else. He never told me to do anything else. He had said go on the website and look for something. I would have done that.
And someone that deals with complaints in your line of work, you dealt with complaints, so you know, you can take it a step further if you want to.
Well, not in my line of work, because I don't get complaints about myself. If someone were going to call, one of my members was going to call and complain about me, I would answer the phone and say, okay, this is, yeah, you're complaining about Joanne Fisher? Oh, okay, I'll look into it and hang up. I'd give them to my president and my boss and say, you have a complaint about me, you need to talk to them. I would never do that.
Did Lieutenant Sawicki, at any time that he questioned you about this, ever cite to any policy that he made you aware of that he believed Captain Brown was violated by fielding your call?
No. He only said whatever he asked me on I don't quite understand what you mean. Okay.
Well, did he tell you that what Captain Brown did in taking your call on October 23rd or 13th was a violation of any policy within the sheriff's office?
No, I don't believe so, no. I don't remember having that conversation. But.
Fish, I meant to go.
You ever think about going to the press?
No, because as I said, my mom's really just nervous about that kind of stuff. We didn't seek any legal things. My mom just wanted to get out.
I certainly respect that.
Yeah, we didn't want to, she didn't want to do anything.
I have a question. Mm-hmm. So you and your mother talked about furthering this complaint. Get your mother from it. Did you want to file a complaint? Did you want to go further with it?
I would have probably, the sheriff at the time, Dan Johnson, I probably would have called him, but she didn't want.
And why? What made you, why would you want to do that? Why do you want to go further with it?
Well, because it was very upsetting, and I feel like maybe this has happened to other people that wouldn't file a complaint, because things happen to people. And the way he spoke to her and said, you're lucky you're not going to jail, is almost a way to talk people into not filing a complaint. So, I would have continued it, but when I told her, do you want me to contact somebody else, she said no. She just really.
So then you stopped in deference to your mother?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
One further question. We talked about the impression left on you by this interaction. How does it make you feel that this action might have been a factor in his dismissal? Does that make you feel better about the way the sheriff's department handled the follow-up to this case?
Well, definitely if it was included, yes. That's why we made the point to come, that I came here to make sure my mother would come. And they've been very professional since we've been in contact with them since. Complaint has continued. does have a better feeling, and I have a much better feeling about it, but it's been pursued.
Any other questions? Do you wish to see it be held over?
No, sir.
In that case, well, thank you for your time and your testimony, and look forward to that.
Okay, thank you.